Let me now outline a proof of the central limit theorem. This proof starts with the evolution equation of the probability distribution itself after a single step. So let me write Pn of x. What is the probability that after n steps I'm at position x? How can this happen? In order to be at position x at the n step, I had to be somewhere else at the n minus first step, so Pn minus 1 of x prime. And then in a single step, I went from x prime to x, so little p x prime going to x dx prime. So again, this equation, which is known as the Chapman-Komarov equation, expresses that in order to be at position x at the nth step, I was somewhere else at the n minus first step, and then I made a hop from the somewhere else to x, and then I have to integrate over all these intermediate somewhere else's in order to get to x. Now, in order to make progress with this, to simplify this, I'm going to make use of Fourier transform technology, and note that this object is known as a convolution because we go from x prime to x by this single step. And so if I Fourier transform this equation, convolution in real space turns out to be multiplication in Fourier space. So after the Fourier transform, we have the much simpler statement that Pn of k, and again, the k is to emphasize that we have now the Fourier transform function. So Pn of k is not Pn of x with x replaced by k, but it's a different function altogether, the Fourier transform, and it's equal to Pn minus 1 of k times little p of k. And so I can now take this recursion formula and just recurse it all the way down to the start of the walk, and infer that, let's just do it one step at a time. So Pn minus 1, well, that's nothing more than Pn minus 2 of k times little p of k squared. And I just continue this process to the very end. And what I'm going to get then is that this is equal to P0 of k times little p to the power n. But again, if we imagine that the particle starts at the origin, then this that means Pn, P0 at x is a delta function at x. Its Fourier transform is just 1. And so this just reduces to little p of k to the power n. And now to find the probability distribution as a function of x, we just have to inverse Fourier transform Pn of k. So let's write that out. So Pn of x is equal to 1 over 2 pi, the integral minus, so over all space, and so it's going to be p of k to the power n e to the I k x. Let me do this in one dimension because in higher dimensions there's no conceptual difference, it's just more clunky. So let's do this as an integral from minus infinity to plus infinity dk, one-dimensional integration. But now what I'm going to make use of the fact that the single step distribution has this feature that the mean displacement, the mean square displacement are finite. So let's now return to little p of k, which was equal to it's a Fourier transform of little p of x. So p of x e to the I k x dx. And let's just expand this in a Taylor series. So we have p of x, I have 1 plus ikx minus k squared x squared over 2 plus higher order terms dx. And let's identify each one of these terms. So the first term, p of x, 1 dx. So this is the probability that I hop anywhere in a single step. And by construction, this is equal to 1. The next term, well, the ik comes out in front, and then I have the integral of p of x, x dx. And this is nothing more than the mean displacement after a single step. So this is ik x average. And similarly, for the second term, we have k squared over 2, and then I have the integral p of x, x squared dx, which is nothing more than the mean square displacement after a single step, plus higher order terms. To make the rest of this outline of a proof simpler, let me just restrict myself to the symmetrical case, and I'll leave as an exercise for the student to worry about the asymmetrical case. So I'm going to just forget about this term, assuming that the random walk is symmetrical. So now what I'm going to use is that I'll plug in this p of k back into this integral for pn of x. So pn of x is equal to 1 over 2 pi, the integral of quantity 1 minus k squared x squared average over 2, and it's to the raised to the power n, e to the minus I k x dk. And now I make use of the fact that I'm interested in the limit of large n and small k. Small k corresponds to large x in the Fourier domain. And so I can approximate this object here by the exponential. So this is asymptotically going to 1 over 2 pi e to the minus n k squared x squared average over 2 times minus I k x dx. And now I make use of the fact that the Fourier transform of a Gaussian function in k is a Gaussian function. And so I finally end up, again, I'm skipping all of the simple algebraic steps, which I leave as an exercise for the student to do, is 1 over the square root of 2 pi n x squared average e to the minus x squared divided by 2n x squared average. So this is just the central limit theorem for the case of a symmetrical walk in which the mean displacement in a single step is zero. So again, the thing that I want to emphasize is that this distribution is Gaussian, and furthermore, it is independent of almost all details of the individual steps. So this universal behavior is a powerful unifying theme in many problems in statistical physics, and it played an important role in the development of the theory of random walks.